This is a guidebook to a software of limitless potential and outdated mechanisms. Abandonware for ears. For everyone expecting a cool SFM animation, flee as this is the opposite. Wink wink, bruh. I'd expect you to already know the basics of SFM and to already have experienced the ludicrous errors and glitches the software would throw at you. Timestamps are in the description, so you can jump to whatever you would need to fix or figure out. Wrapping up the chit chat, let us progress into the realm of... I couldn't scroll fast enough.
Heavy is oil!
So you've done your scene, you're happily, you know, you're at the end, you're very happy, and you're like, okay, I'm going to render. But before you render, it's like, you go, you know, explore it in movie, and you save the changes, but I'm not going to save them, reasons, and you're like, oh! What is this? 720p? But they told me I could have 1080, 4K, and 8K! And I get this? What is this piece of?
The reason for your bad luck is that SFM is set to 720 by default. In order for you to scale this up, you gotta make a few tweaks. Which means, you gotta first exit SFM, obviously. So you go to your Steam library where your SFM resides peacefully until you're going to be starting to poke it with very strange commands. Go to Properties, Launch Options, and here I'm going to show you a code which you will insert that will increase the resolution of your rendering capabilities. This is the whole thing, but what does it mean? The resolution is self-explanatory. This is the preview. What is a preview? A preview is when you're watching your video, when you're making it using the work cameras and stuff. So if you want to conserve your GPU, you can remove this. Or you can keep it if you want to keep previewing at the desired resolution. Now this is about rendering. Yeah? So if you want to render it at high capacity, like 1080p, you insert this, and you click OK. And now when you go to export your movie, which you can just press Control M, you're going to see the happy, happy consequence of your capability that is labeled 1080p. That's pretty nice, eh? I'll put in the description if you the settings you have to include if you want to do it 4K or, you know, other settings, whichever you've chosen. You got to understand that if you put higher preview options, this will take more from your CPU and GPU. But if you are a PC master race kingpin, don't worry. Put it to the maximum, throttle away up to the space, cause a black hole. There could be many reasons to why you'd be wanting to launch SFM offline. Maybe you want to go off the grid and, you know, it's understandable. Since you know what you're doing, here's how you can launch this special software without the need to even have an internet connection. As well as Steam, all you need to have is the core files. I want you to go to the folder you installed Steam to, as well as SFM. Then you go to Steam Maps, Common, Source Filmmaker, Game, and here you have sfm.executable. Now, you can add the additional commands directly to it, but I would really tell you not to do that. Right click and create a shortcut. Now this shortcut, you can move it somewhere more convenient. And now we have our shortcut here residing in the folder alone. You go into the properties of this folder, and here we add the command Nosteam. Yeah? Okay, save, and we launch. And if everything's all right, this launched SFM without Steam even being on. But then you'd ask me, but hey, Markovus, how am I supposed to put my launch commands in something that doesn't have set launch options? Well, of course, as you see here, it's 720. You don't want that, right? So you go again to your shortcuts, and you just follow the same logic. And you add your resolution commands, or whatever you want to add to it, the shortcut. And this is now going to act, yeah? This is now going to act like set launch options. Pretty nice, yeah? And the best part of it is, it's running offline. Can you believe that? I can't believe it sometimes, the things that software is capable of, especially abandonware. You can do whatever you want with it. And when we open it, we will have the capability to render 1080p without Steam, offline, off the grid, with an isolated folder structure. Okay, I'm kind of distracting you now. But I want to warn you, even if you're able to do everything you should be able to do offline, you will not have your workshop for items updated. Hell, even they could probably even not work unless you've downloaded them and put them in a separate directory. Glowing textures on the map, and not just textures on the surfaces of the map, on models. Now, Dirty Explorer would ask you here, which do you think is the problematic module? And the problematic module is obviously the fence, the tree, the benches, the steel rods in the distance and speakers. How do you fix it? Mat, bump, map, zero. Plung. Now it does its job. It moves the cogs up and down. And when it's ready, it should reward you. Okay. Look. I move to the left. There, fixed. It's done. You're good. You should leave. You should run. Don't wait. Understand that this bump map is a very important part of games, and that's pretty much the bump map ish. If you want to know more about bump maps, you can call this nut. There are these shiny, weird looking things. They're like a Christmas tree, but this Christmas tree likes to flicker when you actually move the camera. This is a very annoying bug, and I think many of you SFM users have had the indecency to be victimized by it. The simple solution could usually be you type in console mat fast specular, think zero, should be zero, and it fixes it. You see that? And now it's gone. But I also want to show you something else. It's not just these, Christmas tree lights. It's reflections on other surfaces. So if you don't have these Christmas trees, you should look onto your surfaces. And if you see these kind of awful reflect, you see it's like reflecting the skybox around here. Yeah, this is the angle of the skybox. That's the other end. If we use fast specular and it doesn't work, you can use matte specular zero. But before you do this, I want you to go up to the file and save, because it's likely to crash the map. But if fast specular hasn't fixed it, specular zero will definitely fix it. So you do this, you cross your fingers, because it can crash the map, it's very likely. And if it doesn't, I'm going to tell you what you should do in order to have this as a permanent change, because if you save now, you're gonna have the same issue next time. So when you've done this and you see the map is pretty beautiful, right? No more shining Christmas ho 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 lights trying to poke out your eyes and cue everybody who's gonna see your video or whatever you're gonna do. You type, you save. So you type buildcubemaps and you submit. Take note, this is gonna take a little bit of time, maybe fast, maybe slow, depends on your computer's overall. But this is a, in a way, permanent fix, in a way it's like transforms your whole map and fixes it. When it's done, it should give you a wide screen. What you should do now, you should actually just restart SFM. So you've restarted it, you open your save file, and here, when I rebuild the cube maps, my save file contains the same map, but the map no longer has the shiny lights issue. There's also this software called Cube Mapper, which you can download from the internet. What you do is you put your BSP that has issues with these cube maps, which are the shiny lighting things. You pretty much use the tool to convert it. You put the map, you put the executable, whichever it wants, and you start it. And it should, in a way, fix them. I haven't used it much, but if all I mentioned hasn't worked and you're still having trouble with reflective strangeness and Christmas lights, use Cube Mapper. Or at least attempt to use Cube Mapper. There is another annoyance that exists within SFM. It's called Engine Hunk Overflow. So I'm just going to show you what it is in action. For instance, this map usually likes to crash thoroughly. So when you open a problematic map like this, it's going to say Engine Hunk Overflow. And you'll be like, what am I going to do? And it's like, you don't know because there is no guidance book for errors that you can easily just grab from under your desk. So a solution to this Engine Hunk Overflow is very simple. You just type a very simple, I'm repeating a simple word. You just type a basic command in console. r_hunk-alloc-lightmaps0. Enter. And when you are to load the map again, mark is clean. It's not going to tell you Engine Hunk Overflow because you've disabled the light maps. And it's going to load, but if it doesn't load, then the problem is not Hunk Allocate Light Maps. It's something else. But you're one step closer to fixing your problem. And see, we loaded a beautiful Counter-Strike Global Offensive Paris map, which now you can infest with whatever you choose to from your depths of folders and Now I'm going to fill in the void of the silence as your choice hangs between a thread in front of your eyes. Would you choose the left card or you choose the right card? That is the biggest question and the biggest decisions you've ever made. I'd say maybe the left one, but maybe the right.